This is the HomePod Mini, Apple's smart speaker that's priced at 9,900 rupees. It is one of the cheapest accessories that Apple sells, and it is a smaller brother to the original HomePod. And well, if you thought that the original HomePod was a big smart speaker that was very restrictive and was only designed for Apple's ecosystem, this is basically the mini version. My name is Bharat Nagpal, you're watching iGAN, and today we are reviewing the HomePod Mini. Now, Apple has started to understand its consumer base a little bit. Of course, there are people who buy iPhones and spend a lot of money in getting the most expensive, the latest iPhone. But Apple has understood that there is a secondary market that it can tap into, and that market belongs to the iPhone SE, people who buy the previous generation iPhones just because they are that much more affordable. So the HomePod Mini makes its entry at 9,900 rupees, and it's approximately half the price of the original HomePod. With respect to size, it may not be half the size of the original HomePod, and with respect to sound, it may not be half the sound of the original HomePod. We are looking at more one-thirds with respect to size and performance, but it does deliver out on some of the capabilities of the HomePod that we originally liked. And we've done an extensive review of the HomePod. You should click the bubble on the top right to go check out that video if you want to understand what the HomePod is capable of. But with the new iOS update, it also updated some of the features of the HomePod, and you have now some extensive features that allow you to not only play audio or music from various other partners that include things like Pandora Radio or TuneIn Radio. Apart from Apple Music, it still doesn't reach out to the biggest consumer base for India, which includes things like Spotify and other third-party music apps like Gaana or Saavn, etc. Now, if you do have an Apple device, you will need it to set up the HomePod. You can set it up with any portable Apple device, whether it's an iPod, an iPad, or an iPhone. It's pretty simple to set up. You bring your phone close to the HomePod Mini, and it basically does the rest. If you do have multiple people in the house, you can set this up in a family account, and then various people can use their HomePod to answer questions about their personal activities. So everyone can look at their individual reminders. And because Siri is smart enough to recognize who's asking the questions, you get very personalized answers. Also, if you search for a location, that automatically shows up on your phone. If you search the web, that also automatically shows up on your phone. And it depends on who's asking the question, and you get that information on that particular device. So it's become extremely smart with respect to what we were saying about a year or so ago. And it has become quite a capable home speaker for personal requests. Also, it can do lots of smart things. So we have the ability to handle all your home accessories or gadgets. So anything that's connected with HomeKit will automatically be controlled. We use HomePods quite a lot to control the air conditioning, the lighting. Everything in the studio is managed by the Apple HomeKit, and the HomePod Mini also manages to do that without any problem. I do like the new display. It is far more interactive, and since it fills up the full display space, it looks far better than what the original HomePod did with a small glowing light in the middle. There's also the ability to now intercom, and with the new iOS update, you can intercom with not only HomePods, but HomePods can interact with iPhones or iPads. So you can intercom to devices from HomePods and from devices to HomePods, which is absolutely fantastic if you live in a big house and you have several HomePods and you want to send information to, say, everyone that you're leaving. Then everyone can basically be notified without you individually messaging or calling people within your own house.
Hey, intercom to studio, let's go for shoot. Let's go for shoot.
But these features sort of skate off the top of what the HomePod is designed to be. It's designed to be a smart speaker that is also an effective music player. Now, if you have an Apple Music subscription, you're basically sorted because you can ask Siri to play any song or any type of radio or any type of music that you want, and it'll do that. You can also even ask things like play some sleeping music, and it'll play some meditative sounds so that they help you sleep better. If you want some energized songs, you can ask it to play you some energized songs, and it'll help you wake up better in the morning. There's also the ability to play a workout playlist or set up your own playlist and ask Siri to play those playlists for you. So it's a fairly smart audio playing device if that's something that you're looking for. There's another advantage. If you do have an Apple TV, you can use HomePods as external speakers. All you have to do is set them up with the AirPlay within the Apple TV. If everything's on the same Wi-Fi network, they become the external speakers. HomePods can also be paired with each other, and the HomePod Mini allows you to do that as well. So you can pair up two HomePods to set up a stereo pair within a room, and you can get a much more fuller experience. But the audio quality of the HomePod is pretty much there. You get deep bass and good amounts of vocals and really clear highs as well. We compared the HomePod Mini with the Google Nest Mini, the Echo, and the Echo Dot. We found that the HomePod Mini sounded the best out of all of those with respect to a complete wide soundstage with just a small single speaker. We found that the bass levels were really good and the vocals were really clear. In the same setup, we found that the Echo and the Echo Dot performed well with respect to loudness, but with the quality of the audio that we are getting out of the HomePod Mini, I think despite its price tag, it does perform the best, even if it's not the loudest of the lot. It is the most expensive of all the speakers that we did test, and it just goes to show that Apple could have easily priced this speaker slightly lower, but it does want to retain its premium marketplace, and it does manage to do that with the HomePod Mini. Now, if you own an Apple device, an iPhone, an iPod, or even an iPad, the HomePod Mini is a logical option if you're looking for a smart speaker. The HomePod Mini now also has Bluetooth, and it's Bluetooth 5.0, but Apple did not decide to open this. They've basically used Bluetooth 5.0 for a connection experience. But here's the thing, if Apple would have opened up the Bluetooth 5.0 for third-party devices, this could have become the gateway for people to experience Apple or just get into the Apple ecosystem with one of the cheapest available smart devices. But here's the thing, it is a smart play, because if you today own an iPhone and you buy lots of HomePods today, the next year when you're trying to upgrade your iPhone to possibly another Android phone, you will consider the fact that you have so many HomePods and you'll have to get rid of all of them. Or if you get used to the HomePod experience, then you can't get rid of the iPhone. So it pulls you into the Apple experience or the Apple ecosystem that much more, and then you want to stay there. So if you own an Android device, the HomePod Mini is more or less useless for you. But if you own an Apple device, the HomePod Mini is best smart speaker that you can get under 10,000 rupees today. And the larger HomePod still remains the best smart speaker in general if you own an iPhone. That's it for this video. If you enjoyed it, smash the like button, hit the subscribe button if you're not already a part of Team iGAN. If you'd like to check out links to buying the HomePod, we'll leave them in the description below. My name is Bharat Nagpal. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next one.